Welcome to our series of Film Eds. Come join our global classroom as we use foreign film to bring you the world. Global hotspots, world affairs, history and culture all come alive as we see them first in a moving image, a film. Today we're going to travel to Myanmar, also known as Burma, and we're going to meet the lady Aung San Suu Kyi. We're going to see how she sacrificed her personal life to bring peace and democracy to her people. Her strength and her courage brought hope to millions of Burmese, as well as to people around the world who fight for freedom. So let's begin our journey. We're traveling to Myanmar, which is the largest country in Southeast Asia apart from China. It has a population of 60 million people. The country bordering Myanmar in the north is China. In the south is Thailand. In the east are China, Laos, and Thailand. In the west are India and Bangladesh. Let's go back in a time capsule to the end of the 19th century and look at key dates in Burmese history. During the 19th and 20th century, Burma was under British rule for 60 years. In 1940, General Aung San, the lady's father, and 29 comrades are trained in Japan. From 1941 to 1944, they ally Burma to the Axis alongside Japan during World War II. In 1945, General Aung San turns to Britain and negotiates to join the Allies in exchange for Burma's independence after the war. It is also in 1945 that his daughter, his third child, is born. On July 19, 1947, General Aung San and cabinet members are assassinated. On January 4, 1948, Burma is granted independence from British rule. From 1962 to 1988, General Ne Win controls Burma in a ruthless military dictatorship. In 1972, Aung San Suu Kyi and Michael Aris, a Tibetan scholar, marry. In 1988, there are demonstrations in Rangoon, and General Ne Win relinquishes his power. At this time, Suu Kyi returns to Rangoon to take care of her mother. From 1989 to 2010, Aung San Suu Kyi is placed under house arrest, on again, off again, for 15 years, while Burmese generals rule with an iron fist. In 1999, Dr. Michael Aris dies in Oxford of prostate cancer. In January 2011, General Thein Sein becomes president. On April 1, 2012, Suu Kyi's party, the National League for Democracy, wins 43 seats in parliament. I'd like to share with you some photos I took when I was visiting Myanmar in March 2012. The film opens with General Aung San telling a story to his two-year-old daughter, who will be our heroine in the film. He calls the story the Golden Land of Burma before it was colonized by the British. Golden because of the thousands of Buddhist pagodas and temples throughout the country. These are photos of a political rally I took before the elections when the Ladies' Party, the National League for Democracy, won 43 seats in parliament. This is Pagan, the ancient capital of Burma 1,000 years ago. It's near Mandalay, where there are more than 3,000 remaining Buddhist temples, pagodas, and monasteries dating from the 9th to 13th centuries. Children as young as 5 years old are going to live in a monastery for 1 or 2 weeks to learn about Buddhism. Inner Lake is located in the central eastern region called the Shan Plateau, and is inhabited by several ethnic groups, especially the Paos. The makeup is sunblock from the shaved powder of a local tree. The lake is made up of floating islands where the roots are extremely deep, so deep that the fishermen have to row with one leg. They sit down, they can't see the floating plants and reeds. Buddhist pagodas in the countryside north of Mandalay. the Burmese people so good and full of life. This is Ma Maison, now a restaurant in Yangon. During World War II, it was the house of General Aung San's best friend, and it served as the general's war office. This is outside the lady's house on Inya Lake in Yangon. Now please join me as we meet the lady and watch an edited version from our film ed. After the film was made, the lady had been released from house arrest, and Luc Besson, the director, visited her. He gave her a DVD of the film as a gift. She told him, "I have shown courage in my life, but I do not have enough courage to watch a film about myself." Let's see how truly courageous the lady is in our film ed.
Male, a champagne mukin shimbone, do a tet to an out at some social book, in my tongue a yeji body.
Ari, you know the meal, PM, and I'll be Haza.
Okay.
The soldiers, they look very serious. We should come with some of the day.
No. Just ignore them. We will continue in a calm and orderly fashion. Stay here first.
Based on the film you have just seen, let's review some important points. Who are the following people? General Aung San, General Ne Win, students of 1988, ethnic tribe Kayan, Hmong's protest of 2007, the Saffron Revolution. What has happened in Myanmar since the film's release? General Thein Sein is president. Under his rule, Aung San Suu Kyi was released from house arrest on November 13, 2010. On April 1, 2012, free elections for parliament were held. The National League for Democracy won 43 seats, but this represents less than 7% of all parliamentary seats. Many political prisoners and members of the National League for Democracy Party have been released. Sanctions from US, UN, and international countries have been lifted. Based on the film, here are some suggested questions for group discussion. What was life like for Aung San Suu Kyi and her husband, Dr. Michael Arris, in Oxford, in Rangoon? Describe the challenges Aung San Suu Kyi confronts. Explain the geopolitical importance of Myanmar within America's foreign policy for developing Asia. Discuss their natural resources, rubies, sapphires, gold, jade, oil, and teakwood. What is the relationship between China and Myanmar? Can the international community trust the government of generals in Myanmar? What is the lady's future for the presidential elections in 2015? What is Myanmar's future?